from the former president to the current president. Interesting, to say the very least, coronavirus press conference yesterday where President Trump discussed that he has more power to open up the economy than the nation's governors. Take a listen.
The president of the United States calls the shots. If we weren't here for the states, you would have had a problem in this country like you've never seen before. We were here to back them up, and we've more than backed them up. We did a job that nobody ever thought was possible. It's a decision for the president of the United States. Now, with that being said, we're going to work with the states because it's very important.
Rick, so does the president, in fact, have the power to do this?
Not really. I mean, we've seen this playing out already. I mean, it has been governors and mayors to some extent, who are making the decisions about what to do in each state. The governor of New York, California, Washington, for example. I mean, this is where the authority resides. These are the people who have been taking all the action. I mean, Trump has actually backed away from taking action, and he has said up till now it is up to the states to do this stuff, especially with regard to testing, which we need way more of. He has actually said, look, we're the federal government. It's not our job to do testing on every street corner. It's up to the states and the governors. It seems like what's happening here, Brian, is Trump is seeing governors like Andrew Cuomo in New York, Gavin Newsom in California, Jay Inslee in Washington, and some others. I mean, their approval ratings are going up quite a lot because they're actively managing the crisis. They're taking bold action, and many citizens appreciate what the governors are doing. Trump's approval ratings are going in the opposite direction. They're dipping. In the Rasmussen poll, which normally has Trump over 50%, he is down to a 43% approval rating. So I think he wants some of the credibility that the governors are getting. But I don't think this is the way to get it, to just say, I'm going to tell the governors what to do if I feel like it. I don't think anybody wants to hear that from the president.
And hey, Rick, this morning we're hearing there might be another candidate in the 2020 election. We've got Congressman Justin Amash of Michigan. He's a former Republican who left the GOP last summer. Famously, Trump called this congressman a total loser and said he was disrespectful for wanting to impeach Trump. I mean, look, obviously, super long shot for Congressman Amash here, but does this just swing the momentum away from Trump as we move closer to the November election?
Yeah, Justin Amash is an interesting case. He was a Republican who has defied Trump and basically went his own way. He's not the candidate yet for the Libertarian Party, but the Libertarian Party is a kind of a small, I guess you could call it a third party here in the United States. Gary Johnson was a Libertarian candidate back in 2016. And he got a percentage point or two. The only reason this really matters is not because a guy like Justin Amash could win, but he could potentially take votes from somebody. So the real question is, if he could get, even if it's just one percentage point of the vote, who would that come from? Would that be more likely to come from Trump or more likely to come from Biden? And I don't actually know the answer right now. I guess it would depend, number one, is he going to be the nominee? And then how would he position himself? So we'll see. He could take some votes away from Trump because he's somewhat conservative, but he might appeal to independents who account for a major portion of the swing voters.
You know, Rick, I'm sure you saw the press conference yesterday. Do you think that performance by the president should make investors worry that he has lost control of the situation to, I guess, handle the current situation, but also reopen the economy and articulate a clear plan? You're seeing the market rally, I think, under the notion that maybe the economy will reopen and it may go somewhat smoothly.
The big picture for investors, I think, is not what's the play based on something Trump may or may not say in one of these briefings. But to calculate in the odds that Joe Biden might actually be the president come January, Biden does favor some tax increases and some other things that would be a significant departure from the Trump agenda. He does not favor Medicare for all, but he would regulate the healthcare industry more than Trump would, for sure. He would also expand federal options for healthcare, which could have implications for insurers and others in the healthcare industry. I think this is, Trump honestly seems to be sort of spiraling down at this point. His reelection odds, I think, are declining. And I think that's what investors need to be thinking about, is the increasing likelihood of Joe Biden as president.
All right, let's leave it there. Rick Newman, always good to talk with you.
See you guys.
Hey, investors, Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.